the Minerals and Petroleum Resources Development Act 28 of 2002, mining companies need to contribute to social upliftment of areas where they operate. Why did this act come about? It came about because before the Minerals Act was utilized, and within the Minerals Act there was no social and labor plan nor black economic empowerment aspects. The main purpose of the Minerals and Petroleum Resources Development Act, we call it the MPRDA, is because previously there was a Minerals Act that did not make provision for black economic empowerment and for social and labor plan, which are the two instruments that we use to transform the mining industry. We know in our country that historically mining has been a male-dominated area, and also migrant labor, where people were just taken and working in mines, and thereafter when they reach a certain age or they can't perform anymore, they just go back to the rural areas. So mining has had such an impact socially and also in terms of the health of people, because there were no provisions such as health and safety, for example, that are enshrined in the MPRDA. Now, mines would mine and they would leave because there are no more resources. They would exploit all the resources. When they don't find anything left, they would just leave without giving back to the community and not giving back to the labor. So in terms of avoiding leaving ghost towns, something that happened in many years ago, especially during the apartheid era, mining companies now in the democratic context with the MPRDA, we are bridging that gap. We are redressing the imbalances of the past, and how we do that is through the regulation and through monitoring of black economic empowerment and social and labor plan in the country. Okay, the most significant aspect is sustainability of projects, and that mines need to leave a legacy behind, because we all know that mining is not permanent. There are specific time frames linked to the availability of the resources that are being mined. Now, if each and every company does sustainable projects in liaison with the local municipalities, those projects will definitely be sustainable, because the municipality also has a role to play, an oversight role to play, because they are local government and they're directly where the communities are. So these projects become a success because of that. Thank you very much.
Die ACVV is 'n DCPO volgens die Kinderwet. Dit beteken Designated Child Protection Organisation, en ons lewer kinderbeskermingsdienste binne die raamwerk van die Kinderwet. 'N maatskaplike werker soos Selvine werk byvoorbeeld in 'n gemeenskap met kinders, en kinders woon in gesinne, en gesinne bestaan uit ouers en tannies en broers en susters. Ons werk meeste van die tyd daar waar gevalle aangemeld word waar kinders verwaarloos word of kinders mishandel word. En Selvine gaan nou vanuit hierdie gebou in Abbotsdale daardie dienste lewer in Abbotsdale gemeenskap.
Ek wil graag vir julle sê baie dankie, want ek dink Swartland munisipaliteit is baie trots op die trots. En dit wat hier staan, denk ek is tot voordeel vir die gemeenskap. En ek weet eintlik met die ACVV wat dit ook gaan bedryf.
Abbotsdale is vandag trots Tiptrans.
Danani, ons is vanoggend hier in Mamasbury by die opening van die ACVV Mamasbury Assembly Point, wat die fasiliteit sal dien vir social upliftment, vir women upliftment en vir community upliftment, dat die mense makliker toegang het om in hierdie moeilike omstandighede 'n portaal te het waarop hulle kan hulle omstandighede kan klank word met die baie bekwame ACVV span wat sal vir hulle hier sal te help wees. Ons daag ander maatskappye uit om in hierdie moeilike tye ons gemeenskappe te help, ons vrouens te help, ons kinders te help om ons gemeenskappe beter plekke te maak. En ons wens die ACVV en die hele span alle sterkte en sukses toe, en ons sal graag oor 'n jaar kom kyk die vordering hierso en ja, die stand van sake.
In 2014 is die projek geloods saam met die Swartland munisipaliteit en die DMR. En in 2015 het ons die ooreenkomste aangegaan met die tekening van die drie maatskappye, nou Red Hill en Global Black Trading en Tiptrans, om die projek te loods. En toe is die planne goed opgestel 23, laat 2016 goedgekeur uiteindelik. En in 2017 oktober het ons begin bou en dous ons land.